staring back at them from the looking glass. Questions they must answer themselves. The crown, can they keep it for China? Their promise, will it be fulfilled? The pressure, will it be overcome? The window of opportunity is open. Who will go through it? The pairs free skate. And we welcome you back to the city of Gothenburg. Roughly a half a million people here on the southwest coast of Sweden. And the top annual event in skating taking place. And the table has been set. A gold medal out there to be won as we bring you back inside the arena known as the Scandinavium. And it is the pairs. They're out there warming up to skate here for the gold medal. Terry Gannon back with Peter Carruthers. Thrilled to have you alongside. And Peter certainly knows all about what it's like. This moment right before you take the ice. And 1982, the Olympic or the world bronze medal, the silver medal too. Especially the Americans, you know what they're going through. Two teams here who have spent, Peter, a lot of time away from the ice this year for different reasons, but here they are at the World Championships. What can we expect?
Well, I think there's some disappointment that the Americans are down in 10th and 12th place, but beginning with Rena Inoue and John Baldwin, a couple of minutes ago I checked in with their coach, Philip Mills, and he said that they're actually going to do a split double twist rather than the split triple twist that they tried in the short program. Now, the triple twist was quite messy. He said, we want to go for quality and not quantity. I think it's a wise choice if they have any hope of having a good program. And then as far as Castile and Okolski are concerned, their coach, Johnny John, said that for Brooke, she actually performs better in the free program. The free program is longer than the short program. It's more strenuous. It's a pretty arduous thing to get through. It takes a lot of stamina, but he said she tends to settle down, and they have very good statistics as far as how well they do in the free program, and he thinks they'll do okay in this.
Interesting, even though she's battled with an injury the past couple, in fact, several injuries the past couple of seasons, but feeling that they do better in the long. Check out the standings after the short. Zhang and Zhang, it's a great battle at the top. Savchenko and Szolkowy came in as the favorites. Now they trail a little less than 2.5 points. Kawaguchi and Smirnov trying to return Russia to their former glory. They're less than a point out of second right now. And the Americans, Inoue and Baldwin, along with Castile and Okolski, in 10th and 12th, looking good to earn two spots in L.A. next year at the World Championships. Those placements only have to add up to 28 or less.
Representing the United States of America, Rena Inoue and John Baldwin.
So we get things started with one of the American teams. Rena Inoue and John Baldwin Jr., the veterans, in 10th place after the short program. Rena, 31 years of age from Tokyo. John is 34 from Santa Monica, California. And last year, a disappointing world championship in Tokyo. They were hoping to make the podium. They came in 4th the year before. They ended up 8th. And afterwards, Rena said, that's it. This is our last event. We're done. And they decided to come back short time before Nationals.
Solid start. John has had trouble with the triple toe loops, but very good there. This is what they need.
No triple loop. And Rena hanging on there, pitching forward, causing the ice to fly up, not smooth on the landing.
Peter, where do you think the status of American pair skating is right now? Kiana McLaughlin and Rockne Brubaker, the winners of the national championships, are not here because she is too young. So that's certainly a team to look for in the future. But overall, where is it?
Well, bringing those two up right there gives me a lot of excitement for the future of pair skating in the United States. They're very strong. I watched them on the Grand Prix, and I look forward to seeing them on the world stage.
Is there depth?
With them, there sure is.
No, with the American teams.
I think we can always use more depth. For them personally, this is important. And for points, this is the throw triple axel 3.5 times. And very crooked. She was tilted in the air, and that's what caused the fall.
They were the first to do that. But percentage-wise, at this point, they don't pull it off all that often. You know in her mind, she's got to be thinking, oh, no, when we go into that.
It lost speed. It didn't have a big ending. It went down. And they're terrific skaters, but this performance did not skate up to the level of what you need to be on the podium, certainly at the World Championships.
You mentioned prior to it that they were going to take an element and downgrade it, be a little bit conservative. You think that took over, that way of thinking?
No, I think they just were late to the party this season. You know, they started really training in November. And look what you're up against here with the Germans and the Chinese. You just cannot fool around and decide when you want to start training. You have to be ready all season.
Now, they spent 11 months away from international competition until the recent Four Continents Championship, and she suffered a groin injury there. Awfully difficult.
Now, these were very good. These are the side-by-side triple toe loops. You can see them skating in. Unison's very important. John has struggled in the past, but three rotations right there, those were fine. Had they kept that kind of momentum going through the program, things would have worked well. The throw triple axel, usually she really skates this out and has good coverage across the ice. She gets the height, but she starts to tilt, and when that happens, you get lose your balance, and that's why she couldn't land that.
All right, so waiting for the marks now. And if you saw the national championships, you saw it live, that proposal at the end of the free skate. So Rena and John with 58.81. And then the program components, the old artistic mark, and 103.37, the total for the free skate.
And low for them, considering that the highest they ever receive is 122.27.
Yep, so Inoue and Baldwin, 157.2 their total score.
Representing the United States, Brooke Castile and Benjamin Okolski.
So the other American team taking the ice right now, Brooke Castile, who's 21, from Grosse Pointe Woods, Michigan, and Benjamin Okolski, 23 years of age, from Ann Arbor, and the 2007 U.S. champs, this year the bronze medalists.
She did a single axel, so the team only gets credit for that. They were looking for doubles.
Injuries that she's battled. Originally, it was tendonitis in her foot, which led to a torn MCL, which then led to a pinched sciatic nerve in her back, which led to complete numbness in her left leg.
Series of unfortunate events, really.
Distinguishes them from the rest.
Consistent. When you're on, it's a different program. Without mistakes on the jumps and over rotation on the triple twist, it's a cleaner program. Throw triple loop and see right there, for example, unsure on the landing. Everything's a lot more clear. There's more clarity in the performance. Speed here, overhead lift, one hand. packed program, but mistakes that just did not bring the performance together as a whole. They've had the injury to deal with, and I think that's taken its toll, but working through this system with the points that you have to get to be competitive sometimes gets the best of you. But, you know, Brooke really does have a great personality on the ice. And back to what you said, I would say it's her personality when she's performing well. That's what distinguishes them.
Now, it's not like they haven't been back. She's been injured, but of course they came back, skated at the Nationals, and also skated at the Four Continents Championship where they earned a bronze medal. So they have been back training as of late.
Sometimes you get a little overexcited at the beginning of the program, and that's what happened here. Three-plus rotations. She almost did 3.5, and he had to stop her rotation. So at that point, you say to yourself, and as a team, we've got to settle down a little bit. We're getting too much as far as snap and pop. We've got to just cruise through it with more ease. And there, that was fine. No problem. It's so important to be on the same page and not throw too hard on the various throws.
We'll check their marks in a moment. Right now, Susie Wynn standing by with Inoue and Baldwin.
Rena, John, you were so impressive this season that you were able to compete at the U.S. Championships with so little prep time. Now you're here at the world scene. What are your impressions of the week?
It was a real learning experience for us, really, coming in and learning all the new rules with the new levels. And not doing the Grand Prix Series and trying to compete is always a disadvantage, but we're very happy to even have come this far. And it was a big accomplishment for us to do Nationals and then Four Continents and just show up here. So we're so happy to do a good long program tonight.
Well, good luck to you. You had a big wedding to plan, so we wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Terry?
Now the numbers, you're in the 40s, they wanted better than that. Last year they came in 12th at the World Championships, and their goal was to finish higher than that this year, and that's where they are, at least they were, heading into the free skate. Currently in third, Castile and Okolski from the U.S. Some of the top teams still to come. Pang and Tong from China getting ready. We continue to revisit some of the peak moments from past world championships, including an odd one from 73.
And I believe something has happened. Their music has stopped. They must be on a tape, and the tape must have broken. Of course, it's not necessary for them to continue skating, but they have chosen to do so. And that's the end of the program.
Well, you're watching something that has never happened before in a World Figure Skating Championship.
I listen to the crowd. Their opening move should set the tone of their performance. A split triple twist, very difficult. Must be done with height and a lot of energy and verve. Here it is. Beautiful, beautiful.
That was how it was done back in the early 80s. Mr. Carruthers with his sister, Kitty. You going to critique that for us? Now you're a big commentator, a big star, and you always are taking apart other elements.
Well, you know, for a quarter of a century old, considering that's how long ago it was, you know, it was what it was.
It held up.
Can't
There's
talk
no
about
doubt.
Ourselves.
All right, here we go. The gold medal out there and one of the top teams. And we're going to compare that triple twist to this
coming up. No, come on. Now, hands
Jing
down,
Pang,
these guys.
Zhang Tong from China. Come on. That's fair. Disappointed with their placement right now. Currently in fifth after the short program. And they're the only team in this field here in Sweden that has won a world title. That was in 06.
But true elegant quality throughout this performance. This is how far
a triple twist has come in 25 years. Look at the height on that. A little difference from the day when we did it. That was extraordinary.
Yours is still held up. But theirs is awfully good.
Triple Salchow. The phrasing to the music, excellent. Followed up with a throw triple loop. Again, spectacular.
You watch skating all season in terms of the pairs, and you buy into the hype every now and then. The Germans have taken over. So Kawi, Savchenko, they're going to win the world title. And you watch a performance like this, and you're reminded that the Chinese have been dominant and still are right there at the top or near it.
And you never know what can happen in the heat of the moment. They included very difficult pair moves with good music, good choreography, good use of space on the ice. It was a complete program. Well done.
Qingpeng Zhang Tong, the gold medalist from 06, silver medalist last year in Tokyo, looking for a gold again. They were in fifth after the short. Some ground to make up, but that was great.
The Chinese take their pair skills to a very high level. Look at the height on this split triple twist. She's way over his head, about 10 feet high, and the extension coming out. The speed that they keep throughout the program is good. They never back off, and that's key. They go after it. Throw triple salchow. Very well done. And they followed that up with even more athleticism. The throw triple loop. This was back to back in the program, and watch her punch the landing. Complete control and emotion. Really great to see.
So the marks now, and they should be very high. The 96.81 will hold up what each team needs to lead throughout. But that's not even close here. I mean, they're way past that. 118.91 and the overall total 186.78 for Pang and Tong. Bin Yao, their coach on the right side, single-handedly has created the most powerful pairs program in the world. Right now, we check in with Susie Wynn.
Brooke and Ben, you made it through the World Championship and such a tough season with injuries. What do you take away from the season?
I think we did nationals. Coming back as the defending champions was tough, and we really proved to ourselves and I think to the competition, to the country, you know, that we could do what we did last year. We skated well there. I thought we did a good job, and doing four continents again and medaling was huge for us. We skated really well there. And here was just for the experience. We weren't completely pleased with our skates. We can definitely do much, much better. But we're just going to, you know, try to come away with it with the experience of another world championships mm-hmm. under our belts. And hopefully just take some time off and start fresh for next season. And hopefully everything will go a lot smoother.
Well, we wish you a good rest. And we'll look forward to seeing you next season.
Thanks.
Terry?
All right, Susie, thank you. The top teams still to come, including the Canadians, Dubé and Davison, currently in fourth. And the Germans, Savchenko and Szolkowy, looking for their first gold medal here in Gothenburg. Meanwhile, we roll on with the pairs free skate. Terry Gannon along with Peter Carruthers and Susie Wynn. On the ice right now, Maria Mukhortova and Maxim Trankov from Russia, currently in sixth place after the short program. And a team that's been around the top, never quite to the gold medal spot. At least on the senior level, this team did win a world junior title in 2005. That's a rough start, Mr. Carruthers.
It is. Let's see how they can pick up from here. Oh, wow. Timing issue right there. He throws, she doesn't jump, or she jumps too early and he throws, and that's the result.
And disaster.
Coming unglued. Got to get your head back in the game in spite of the mistakes that have happened. The question is, will it go downhill from here?
Trying to help get them back into it. Thank you. And they have stopped. He's shaking his right hand. Their coach, Oleg Vasilyev, over by the boards, now walking towards the judges. And he's obviously major problems.
Hard to say what that is. Could have. May have sprained it.
And so Maxim Trankov over near the boards now, and they'll take a look at that. The doctor will. Wearing a nice costume. And going all the way up to the shoulder.
I've never seen anything
quite like this.
No.
Right, yeah. Well, we listen in, but unless you know Russian, it's kind of tough.
It almost looks as though his costume was too tight or something. I don't know.
Obviously motioning as if his right hand was numb or he lost the feeling in his right hand, trying to get that back. And they've got the costume. And we saw earlier the memory from 73 when the music stopped, and that's become one of the famous Rodnina and Zaitsev and Dick Button's call, of course, and picking up and continuing on without the music. And now for a Russian team here in 2008, a costume-caused injury, perhaps.
So now the question is, will they continue? Do they want to continue?
You have 3 minutes from the time you stop to pick it up again, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Now, what's left in the program from this point? Is there a lift left? That could be a dangerous proposition.
There's two lifts left.
If that right arm, that right hand is numb or in some way injured, how much confidence would you have going into that? Is absolutely bizarre.
I want to speculate, but I can't imagine what was wrong. But as you pointed out, the lifts at the end now become very uncertain.
And I'm told
and here's one of them right here. That looked normal.
All right. These are new costumes, by the way, since the European Championships. And it appeared that that
was constricting.
It was just too tight.
Here's another lift, the last one. And that's the arm that they cut the material away from. So...
How do you judge that?
Okay, I'll just throw it out there. This is speculation. You're not supposed to do this as a broadcaster, but I think it was too tight and it was constricting him and he was losing circulation. But I could be completely wrong. Very strange.
We'll try to get word somehow. You wonder, too, remember the lift early on, which never happened, or the throw, which never happened. And you wonder if that was actually because of that.
Could have impacted it. But it's just pure speculation at this point.
Maria Mukhortova and Maxim Trankov from Russia with a bizarre program. They won't wear those costumes anymore.
And the timing was way off here. This is the what was supposed to be a split triple twist lift, and he was throwing her too early. She wasn't ready to jump. It was timing issues right from the beginning there, and that just
really started things off badly. And then at the end of the program, you can see the costume that's been cut away. They did that, and it doesn't appear as though, you know, he's kind of grimacing, but the lift is up, it's fully extended, and they got through it.
Maxim still trying to figure out that right arm in the costume, and it looks like it's still too tight up on his body. Yeah, they're going to cut it off now.
Get it off.
Oleg Vasilyev is going to go to the scissors and go ahead and just take that right off. So here are their numbers, almost 51 and 51 and a half, adding up to 102.55.
And the problem with something like this, it just becomes such a distraction, and people aren't really looking at the scores at this point, just what's going on with the arm.
But the fact is, they are in the top three. Susie Wynn will get to the heart of the drama we just saw a moment ago. Pang and Tong still on top. The top contenders still to come, though, here at the World Figure Skating Championships. In Gothenburg, Sweden, we are set. The gold medal on the line. The final group warming up for the Paris Championship. Hi, everybody. Terry Gannon alongside Peter Carruthers. And it is quite a showdown here with this final group. The Zhangs from China on top. But the team that came in as the favorites from Germany, Savchenko and Szolkowy, they're chasing them. How do you see this, Pete?
Well, actually, I do see the Germans winning this championship if they are great. But you cannot underestimate the incredible power of the Chinese pair team of Zhang and Zhang. Where they will overwhelm is on the huge throws and the lifts. They don't have the style the Germans have, but they have the power for sure. And as far as Savchenko and Szolkowy are concerned, they have precision. They have finesse and polish coming out of in and out of every single move that they do. When they make mistakes, that undermines it and will hurt. So it will be that, a showdown.
Savchenko, Szolkowy came in as the favorite. They've got some work to do. On the ice this year, very few problems. Away from the ice, it's been a different story, due at least in part to the fact that their coach, Ingo Stoya, was an informant for the Stasi, the former East German secret police.
I would say it was, so far, a very good season. So we had good Grand Prix, good results, good programs, and second time European champion, and this time hopefully world champion, so good season. The situation between the federation and us, it's really hard to describe. There's not so much of support, and we have different opinions, and we have our coach Ingo Steuer, and we want to work together with him, and he did maybe some things wrong in his past, and we have to pay for that.
And the German Federation refuses to fund the team because of their association with Ingo Steuer, and he is suing them because of that. So it's a soap opera that continues, but they are still one of the top teams in the world looking for a world title. Don't forget about those just outside the headliners, like the Canadians, Jessica Dubé, Bryce Davison. Quite a jump for them. They're currently in fourth place. The last couple of years, they finished seventh at the World Championships. And less than 6 points out of first right now, less than three out of the bronze medal position. By the way, Susie Wynn tells us she has spoken to Oleg Vasilyev, the coach of Maxim Trankov. He tells her that Trankov has had a circulatory condition and it acted up earlier today. They thought about not skating. The tightness of the costume did add to the problem. He's being checked out by doctors right now, but he was somewhat concerned to stay on top of it.
Wonderfully done. Double axles, one after the other. Beautifully done.
Very confident team that's on top of its game right now.
And believe me, they've got a good one going.
In fourth after the short and putting pressure on the other top teams.
To tell a story on the ice, have a relationship with good, clean skating where you're not watching a team race to get these points. That was smooth. It had good flow. It was a joy.
There was poise to that program.
Correct.
Jessica Dubé and Bryce Davison, and reflect back to that time last year in February when in the side-by-side spins, his blade tore open the gash in her face. She comes back, a lot of courage.
To say the least, the lifts were wonderful. Why? Because the coverage. This lift goes from one end of the ice to the other. Don't forget, 200 feet long. And that shows to me that they really have great skating skills. Hard to do, but fantastic. And here's a little history for them. This is the first time they've landed the triple lutz. That is the throw triple lutz in competition. The hand goes down a little bit, but still, it really didn't hurt the performance at all. They kept a nice flow moving through the entire time.
Just one more thought on the word courage, which I think is overused in sports. It's not coming back from a 15-point deficit in the second half to win. It's coming back after an injury like this to go right back on the ice, do spins again, and get to this level.
Unbelievable. I was there when it happened, and it absolutely just took the breath away of the entire building. She came back with courage and strength, and they get stronger and stronger.
And some in the building just now realizing they are on top. They have supplanted Pang and Tong on top of the leaderboard. Dubé and Davison from Canada.
From China, Dan Zhang and Hao Zhang.
So we roll on with the leaders now. This will be the challenge right here. We just saw a terrific program from the Canadians, but Dan and Hao Zhang from China had the lead after the short, about 2.36 points, and that's the important thing under this system, the points. They're the Olympic silver medalist. They won the silver medal in 06 at the World Championships. Now they want their first goal.
For her. Dawn missing her double. But this is amazing. Look at that fantastic split, triple twist, beautiful height execution. One hand press right there.
Has won four of the last six gold medals at the World Championships. Russia captured the other two with Domianina and Marina in 04 and 05. Shen and Zhao, the headliners. They carved the way along with their coach Bin Yao, who created the whole pairs program in China. They're three-time world champs, Pang and Tong, 1 and 06. This team looking for number one.
Very important right here. Throw triple loop, three rotations. And she effortlessly lands that. They got through it. They overwhelmed me with some pair elements in that program, but it didn't completely blow me away the way they have in the past. I've seen this happen with them. I take nothing away from the extraordinary athletic talent they have, but at times I feel there's just not a strong rapport between the two of them to give me emotion in the performance.
It didn't elicit any visceral reaction. Your gut kind of went, eh, it's okay. Which it's better than okay, but that's the feeling you had when they were out there, right?
Correct. That's very well put. And that's something that is hard to say when you see things like this. Look at the incredible split triple twist. Their elements hit the highest level that you can get in terms of the extraordinary height and lift that they get. And this is amazing. Watch him press her one hand. What makes it so hard is the fact that he has to keep that in control, because if he doesn't with that one hand, it starts to swing and they can have a fall, and that could be a disaster. So, I mean, these are the items, the skills that are going to bring in the huge points for them as far as the technical element score is concerned, following right through for this throw triple loop. Bang.
The elements are there, there's no doubt about it. And they were for Dubé and Davison, who are standing by with Susie now.
Thanks, Terry. Jessica, Bryce, a wonderful performance. You've had an up and down year, a great Grand Prix series, and then at the Canadians you lost your title, but you're back in the game. What's made the difference this season?
Well,
I think it's just we really trained hard this summer, and we've been healthy all year compared to the last few years where Jess has had knee surgery. So I think that helped a lot. And just knowing when to peak and knowing when to relax a little bit has helped a lot.
Well, good luck to you both. It was enjoyable. Thank you. Good luck.
Knowing when to peak.
It's exactly the case that when you're at the World Championships, the athletes have so much, a very busy season with the Grand Prix.
And for the Canadians, by far a personal best. Now remember, they were 5.7 points behind the Zhang, so that's a tough one to make up. They need 118.43.
Yeah, I just want to add this, Terry. You know Shen and Zhao, of course, the incredible legacy they put down to lead them. The emotion that we would feel between them, that's what we want to see with these two, and they want to develop that.
But certainly, and that number is good enough to get back to the top right now. So Zhang and Zhang, look at the relief on the faces.
They skated well.
They thought there was a chance they wouldn't be in first after that performance, though. And Bin Yao, stoic, as always. Yep, you're in first. But the other top team and the favorites coming in, taking the ice right now.
And it all comes down to this.
The Russians still to come, Kawaguchi and Smirnov, but they were kind of outsiders trying to break through. And right now they're in third. This team, Aliona, Savchenko, Robin Szolkowy, they've enjoyed a great season. Almost undefeated. The only team to beat them, Zhang and Zhang, who are in the lead. The reigning world bronze medalists.
Beautiful.
good cover-up.
It really was. The first set almost got away from them. Spread eagle position is so hard to hold like that. And that will really hurt in the points. Do they wish they could rewind just a little bit? That throw triple Saukow at the end was great. But where was the mistake? On the side-by-side triple Saukows.
That one major mistake may do them in. Imagine how strong the bond must be between Savchenko and Szolkowy and their coach, Ingo Stoya, who won a world title, by the way, with Mandy Vozzo back in 97. And how easy it would have been to walk away from Stoya. Not being funded, having to go on the internet, fan clubs and the like to try to raise money for their skating because of Stoya, but they have stayed with him. And how meaningful a world title would be to Ingo, too.
And I really feel it has hardened them as competitors.
So we'll get the marks for Savchenko and Szolkowy in just a moment. And then it's the Russians, Kawaguchi and Smirnov. If they're in half a good a shape as their coach, there she is, Tamara Moskvina, they have a shot. Tamara right now teaches us how to relieve tension the Moskvina way.
You go down to your hands, make this, and then do this. And keep this position for 10 seconds. Can you manage that? Breathe and think that it's not as difficult as to skate short or long program.
Back in the kiss and cry, and there are the Germans, Savchenko, Szolkowy, and Ingo Stoya, waiting for the marks.
Side-by-side triple Saukows did not work for them. They were very good in the beginning on the toe loose, but right here you can see both making mistakes here, a very awkward moment. That, unfortunately, was not good in the program. However, here's a comparison. Take a look at the height difference. The Chinese of Zhang and Zhang on the left, tremendous height. She's 10 feet in the air, a clear, easy catch, and a good run out. Now, it'll be interesting to see in direct comparison. Let's see how Savchenko and Szolkowy hit it. They're still up in the air, but notice, not quite as high. Yeah. These are the fine little details that separate the technical element score.
It's a great look. Absolutely. So we'll see. And your sense is it's not enough, correct?
Don't forget, the component scores are judged regardless of what's happened with the mistakes.
Not as clear cut. Before we went to break, I had the sense that you had already given it to the Zhangs. Maybe not. 68.77. Program and components over 63, they, Peter.
They have beaten them.
202.86, Savchenko. Szolkowy, they don't really know it yet. They're in the lead. And now they do. The wide smile on the face of Ingo Stoya. Kind of a reserved reaction.
Well, they didn't skate their best.
The major mistake didn't come back to haunt them. But it's not entirely over yet.
From Russia, Yuko Kawaguchi and Alexander Smirnov.
Tamara might have the worst seat in the house. Barely able to see over that rink board. Can you do that, by the way, what she did going to break?
I'm going to try it after we get off the air. That's because it looks hard.
So if you show up tomorrow with a broken elbow, we know what happened to it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yuko Kawaguchi, Alexander Smirnov from Russia, the bronze medalist recently at the European Championships, the reigning Russian champs now, and a team that is on the move and trying to carry on that Russian tradition in third after the short.
Quadruple Saukow? How about that?
Say it again.
Throw quadruple Saukow.
Yeah, that's right. Not triple, quad.
Yes. Nervous mistake right there on the side-by-side triples.
Yes, difficult, but moving at a snail's pace at the end.
But innovative.
Don't argue that. Match just on the takeoff. Forget the jump for a minute, just the way they looked as they stretched out. Unison problem. Very difficult dismount there on the 1 foot, gaining more points.
Right in front of their coach, who was shouting instructions. She might be short, but you can hear her across the rink. Think about that battle for third and the bronze medal. Fighting with Dubé and Davison. Remember how good they were. In fact, their free skate, the Canadians, was judged better than Zhang and Zhang. They beat the Chinese in the free skate portion. They're currently in third. This team was more than 2 points ahead of them after the short. Doesn't want to let go. And they don't want to leave the ice.
There were moments and times in that performance where everything was very nice. But then there were times when the unison didn't feel intact. And I was sort of in and out of that performance. You can't discredit the fact that Tamara Mosvina puts down great programs and innovative lifts. But to me, it was a little hot and cold.
So the flags of Japan and of Russia, Yuko Kawaguchi, Alexander Smirnov. No matter what, it's a huge leap for them. They came in ninth at the World Championships last year in Tokyo. And here they are trying to medal. Will Tamara Mosvina have another world medalist? We'll see. It might be close. Dubé and Davison were so good, though.
Yes, the throw quadruple Savchenko right at the beginning of the program. Four rotations. Did she touch down a little bit? Yes, a very small little mistake, but getting some big points there. That's important, the technical element score. And then the throw triple loop. It's important that he doesn't throw her too hard or too high. And there, that was fine. A little bit far forward for Yuko, but she managed that. And, of course, the biggest manager of them all is right there, even though she's not very tall.
Running commentary the whole time. She's great. But the fact is, Robin doesn't have much to worry about right now. The gold medal, really not in question. It's whether or not Tamara's squad can make it to the podium. There's still out of breath. And still waiting for the numbers. So here they are. To medal, they need 121.37.
Boy, that quad paying off there, 61, but still behind
Davison and Dubé.
Yeah, there it is. Less than 2 points, though. 191.33. So a very disappointed Kawaguchi and Smirnov, along with Moskvina in the kissing cry. They're not able to make it to the podium. So here are your final results. Savchenko and Szolkowy, just an outstanding year. They capture the gold for the first time. The Zhangs from China settle for the silver. And what a performance from Dubé and Davis. And the first time since 01 that Canada has had a pair on the podium. That's when Salet and Pelletier won the gold medal. But tonight, as we check out Inoue and Baldwin and Castile and Okolski, giving the U.S., by the way, two spots next year in L.A. at the World Championships. Tonight belonged to the German team. Aliona Savchenko, Robin Szolkowy skate to the gold medal. An emotional night for them here in Gothenburg. As we send it over to Susie Wynn.
Congratulations, Robin and Aliona. It's been 11 years since a German couple has stood on the top of the podium here at Worlds. What are your emotions? Tell us about it.
I think it's a great moment for us, of course, for our coach. He won the last gold medal 11 years ago, like you said. And, of course, a big moment for Germany and, yeah, for figure skating in Germany.
So you finally got that medal that has eluded you. What are your feelings about that?
it's I don't know what to say now, so maybe it's better to ask me tomorrow, but okay. Then it's late. But well, it's a really great feeling, so it's perfect.
Congratulations to both of you. Enjoy.
So that does it tonight, the opening night of coverage here at the 2008 World Figure Skating Championships. Don't forget, though, more coverage coming your way. Right here on ESPN, we've got the Ice Dance Championship along with the Ladies Short Program tomorrow night. That gets underway at 7:30 Eastern Time. For our entire ESPN crew, I'm Terry Gannon. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. See you tomorrow night from Gothenburg, everybody.